did it all by myself.
Happy golden anniversary, Henry and Elma, from Buddy Crampton. Now, I hope he didn't go through that many cards.
No, he sent me after.
Oh, your anniversary, all about couples.
He told me what he wanted.
Some couples like to stay at home while some go out at night. Some couples are compatible while others always fight. Some prefer the country life while others like the city. Some are dull and boring, and some others fun and witty.
Frankie Jackie's story was right there about the ghost in this house and everything else. There's one there. I guarantee you, it would be like a covey of quail.
They make me go to the door. And yeah. Grandma, you know, was about this big around.
Yeah.
She had a white sheet over. And of course, I was little. And she looked huge to me.
Just go
that was place. One of the advantages of being the baby. I was abused.
No.
That's why I'm like I am.
Well, you know, we'd gather under the steps were under the.
There was a closet under the stairway that
under the stairway.
Upstairs. Yeah.
And we'd get in there in the dark.
Stacking.
And I put a candle in
there. A ghost story. And I told him so good, sometime I got scared.
I'm telling you, there was so many little things out there as child, children. And you really, you say, well, your childhood memories and stuff like that. That to me,
I was fortunate like you were, brother.
Huh?
I was fortunate like you.
Oh.
I spent all my time down in the country with him. Grandma and him.
Yeah.
Mommy, who was lucky enough to get the duck?
Alec?
Yeah.
Oh, Mary. Was it Mary?
It was Alec.
I don't remember.
Yeah, right.
Alec.
The duck.
You know, I had to come
catch the duck.
Yeah, I had
the duck made a mark on
them. Yeah. I had the contest, you know, and I said the first one to catch a duck, you know. And
seemed like it was Alec.
So
yeah,
Alec,
he pushed everybody out of the way.
He had the duck, and the duck I wanted to be his cue. So he did.
He just whistled instead of holding up his hand.
Yeah. We laughed about that.
Of course, we were exclusive. We were almost like a country club. See, we had tennis courts and swimming pools and everything else out there.
Oh, she told me she was a country girl and then told me she had the indoor club.
He said,
yeah.
No way I was a country girl.
Well, you know, that the reason we had that was on account of grandfather, and he was very prominent, and that was a regular mansion out there. So
Elmwood.
For the day.
Yeah, for the day. And of course, you could see through the wall someplace.
Yeah.
Even though it was a mansion. And you go in there, and we had a bath, but it was on the porch, out
the
kitchen,
the
and then you go out and
into
the
gate,
porch.
Through the door.
And you
and
just freeze back then. What we do, Mother put some water on and heat it in the kitchen, and we carried it out there and poured it in the tub.
And then everybody took a bath as long as they could.
Water froze.
Same water.
Yeah,
same water. Saturday night.
Grandpa
had a
child up. Grandpa had a two-hole and my father hit a rain on Lord's house.
I didn't know anything about two-holes until we moved to town. I went with a friend up to Blackwater to visit her grandmother. And we had to go up the path. And I couldn't imagine such a thing.
Roy and I've talked several times here last year or two or whatever, and getting on to that one lunger out there, you know, the water pumps and everything.
Yeah.
I had to come out and get it cranked again and work on it.
We always wound up with spare parts. And after Bubba left, when I would work over the dairy, it was up to me to do everything. And I wasn't as good as Roy, you know, using my hand. And every time I died or something, I'd go out there and work on it, and I'd wind up with some extra parts. And I'd just lay them over somewhere and run.
Lisa, you don't remember the old one cycle engine?
Yeah.
One
engine.
You remember that?
One lung. What do you call them? Hit or miss. That's the trade name today is, and they do take them to these antique car shows and fairs and stuff. And they'll have them out there. These guys have just lovingly restored them. You know, it's fantastic.
You're right. It hit or miss. It didn't fire every time the piston came up. It didn't fire maybe three or four times.
It coast a while.
You remember that one lonely motorcycle we had?
Yes, that one. I was the one that ended up with it.
I walked with it more than
I did too. You sold it to somebody and
for a car.
And then it
for an Essex. For an Essex.
Yeah, and it went to somebody else, and by the time it was over with, I ended up with it. It was 25 horsepower Harley Davidson, and I'd go to pick up a date, and it'd be fine. And I remember I had Mary Dorothy Wideman on the back of that thing.
Whoop, going,
and I started off rolling down 21st, 24th in front of her house, and it caught. And so then I turned and started up that hill. And about halfway up the hill, if it missed, it was back between the transmission chain and everything else, and it had a key on that that locked into that wheel, and that was it. It busts that key every time, and I carried a pocket full of keys and screws and cotter pins, and I'd end up, we'd have to coast back down to her house, and I'd take an hour to put it back together and then crank it, and I'd say, well, it's probably time for me to go home, and then three or four hills over toward 20th Street and home, I'd have to replace it.
That's the reason she wound up with Shorty instead of you.
No, this is not Shorty.
Mary Dorothy.
Mary Dorothy, the older sister.
That's why she didn't get married.
I did. I didn't make it to the church. Here's what I was.
You'd have never made it.
Get to the church. That's the thing that reminded me. How many in this room took the Presbyterian catechism from grandmother?
Oh, everybody did live there.
Yeah.
I got my
That was the thing about the Kennedys. They went out, Frank Jr. said he was over there at the Presbyterian Church one time, but Mud didn't want his mother, Mud Kennedy.
Yeah, Mud.
Didn't want him out of church. He was a Baptist. He was going to be a Baptist. He wasn't supposed to be in it. And Uncle Frank was born and sprinkled and everything a Presbyterian. Right in his church.
He sprinkled Presbyterian.
I found my catechism the other day.
Well, I still think about it.
I've still got my little pink catechism.
I'd love to see that sometime.
Yeah, that's right. It was a little pink.
It's in the box.
Yeah, in there.
It's in one of those boxes.
No, you're a catechism.
She taught me to get married in the Presbyterian church, and I switched over to the Baptist.
Oh, yeah.
You know, the young people.
Silk-stocking in the wind, I was flung out behind that plow from you going
back. You know, we had those horses and a bunch of Holly May. Kennedy was out there. She loved to come out there. And so she wanted to ride a horse. So I got it in front and put her behind me, you know. And we were just sailing along. And I looked up and there was a tree limb. And I ducked and she didn't.
Well, she ducked and she didn't.
I know about that. Who was on the horse with me? And it went under the pecan tree there by the side of the driveway. And of course, I was a little bitty.
Yeah.
But I thought I was as big as everybody else. And somebody was on that horse with me. I don't remember which horse. And it went under that limb, and it just swept me and whoever it was just right off the back end, just as pretty as
it. What was your friend Roberts up the street?
Hugh Roberts.
Yeah, I bet your quarter was him.
Probably was. I had the measles. The only time I guess I've really ever been sick, I had the bad measles. I was in, back then, Mother made me stay in bed 2 weeks.
In a dark room.
Nobody could come in and see you. And Huey used to bring me fruit juice, pineapple juice, and grape juice. And Mother wouldn't let him come in the door, in the room. But one time she let him, she cracked the door and let him speak to me. But he kept So he ate a dry peanut butter sandwich. But see, we were getting ready to go camping last week, and I had put the jelly out in the trailer, so in the refrigerator, so we'd have it out there, and that's the one time that he.
I told us to do a mom 20 years, do you 50 years, it's the first time.
He raised cane, not
two. Jelly to go peanut butter.
Let's all sing to Eddie. Happy birthday to you. It's on the other way.
Happy birthday, dear Eddie. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you, people.
You'll autograph it.
We didn't look like our horses.
That little puppy dog with a broke leg. Or are you just trying to do a curtsy?
No,
did she get it over or something?
Back in 19.
It's always been that way.
I don't know what she's doing it with. My mama got this dog down in Mobile, Ohio. Yeah.
And,
it's, this joint is, that's far as we go back.
Yeah.
It'll work, you just
do.
It's
hips
all over the place.
You got 6 months.
I've never heard her cry out of pain, but she'll bite the hell out of you in a minute.
She said,
hey,
then you
girl.
Gotta go to college.
That's a little
you're gonna be a nurse. You know,
she's about 15, 16 years old. We don't really know how old she is.
Eddie, that tells what took place on the day you were born.
And so she
had and that other one is tells you more in detail.
She still receives some counseling, and much as much at home today.
All right.
Here. We're blessed
and,
that they took care of us so we can go out to the place.
Yeah,
out.
You don't have to pay our debt bill. Like I used to.
They had a little pool like this.
Married.
And
yeah,
got old.
She said, yeah.
She got over there. Goes over there. She gives as much as hard as she does. Probably gets a lot better than that over there.
I can't do that.
Yeah.
It takes
Mama
several days for me to get a straight vibe when I'm sober.
I went to pick you up and started down Highway 45, you know, towards Quidley. And she said, where are you going? I said, well, you said you want to get married. I said, we're going to get married. So we drove up to the courthouse.
That's pretty.
That's Quidley.
Oh, that's pretty.
And went to get on.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is pretty.
just kept washing away the signature.
And about a week or two after we got married, she got a $3 rebate on her income tax. She gave it back to me and said she didn't want to be obligated. So my wedding, they called me.
Yeah, I got a $3 refund for my income tax.
I didn't tell that Cecil.
I said,
paid $2
I don't want to be obligated to you, so I gave it to him.
Oh, she was some darn proud to get this one.
Yeah.
Wendy and I got married in Jackson at the First Baptist Church.
Yeah.
In Jackson?
Yeah.
He was in Foster Town.
So we were in a cafe drinking coffee or something on Saturday afternoon. And Wendy said, "You got the license, didn't you?" I said, "Heck no, I didn't." had all the preacher and the singer
sure.
And everybody already coming there for that wedding and everything, you know. Didn't have a lot. But, you know, back in those days, they kept the courthouse offices open until 5 o'clock all day on Saturday.
Yeah, they did.
And this was about, we got down there about 3:30 or 4 o'clock at the clerk's office and got a license.
Well, we got married on Friday.
Well, we got married on a Sunday, and our 50th wedding anniversary was on a Sunday.
Yep, it'll be a week from tomorrow.
On the 10th.
Yeah. Well, my first one, Mary Jane. Yeah, I have always.
How can you
remember?
Is that number one or number two?
No, that was number one. I know them.
And we went to Brother DuBois' house and got married. And I had an old what? My old Ford or something, old car.
It was a
and
coupe.
Yeah, she said, Mary Jane said, "Where are we going?" I said, "I've always wanted to just take off. You know, not say we're going to so and so." And I just took off, and we headed down toward New Orleans, you know. And we drove for miles and miles, and there's no stations and nothing. And I thought we were going honeymoon on the side of the road. And we barely made it into New Orleans. And what's the name of a big hotel there?
Well, there's so many.
Well,
Roosevelt.
Roosevelt.
New Orleans.
And here we
Monteleone.
Well, this is Roosevelt. Cause they,
right on,
yeah.
Just off.
And here we go in that little old mall, A4, and looked like some hicks, you know. And I didn't know from nothing. Pull up in front there. They come out, got their baggage and got, took the car, you know, and I said, "Oh, goodness. I knew I ought not to get in there."
Lost the car.
Yes, I lost the car. They took us in there, and they gave us a honeymoon suite. And just because, I guess we looked like it.
They
just charged us just like a regular room. And they whined and dined us. I can't get over that, you know, you go in a place like that and they treat you like royalty.
But it didn't take, did it?
Oh, well, yeah, it took
He made the mistake of taking off right after that. You left going to the
service
right after that, didn't you?
Yeah, well, we would have made it, except back in those times, I know you can't tell people nowadays. But really, I didn't make enough to eat and buy clothes and have a place to stay. You had to skip something. And so I worked for her daddy, produce comes in. And I knew I had to do something because she was just staying in a room with an aunt in town, and aunt wasn't charging her much. But I knew I had to make some more money, and her daddy told me that he needed me to go up to Paducah and back and buy produce. And they wouldn't have. They'd be short all around Mississippi. And as fast as I could go up there and come back, he'd want me to turn around and go back. Because it'd be sold. And fact, I had to drive pretty fast. These grocery stores on the way down, they try to flag you down, you know, because it has that shortage, you know. So what I happened in driving the truck, what it really happened, back and forth and back and forth, and Mary Jane was by herself in a room, and her sisters would come by. The oldest one, and you know, I guess they felt sorry for her by herself, and, but they got the kid out the skating rink, and some guy come along and skated right off.
Well, that's
found somebody to stay at home.
Yeah, somebody, and I think it made more money than I did.
Some slick operator came by and skated off with him.
I had a good looking girl. I didn't know who was that. She lived out on 35th Avenue and 20th Street. And I was crazy. I can't remember my name. It wasn't Reed, was it?
You were crazy, but I don't know.
Yeah.
Not 35th and 20th. That's the corner where we are.
That's where Aunt Mary used to live.
Oh, well, this was 8th Street. I meant that.
8th Street, huh?
35th Avenue.
Well, that was right there on the corner. Yeah. That girl had that big house. That's the one you kept sending me back up there to tell her you had to go to work there.
Yeah.
You went down there to that place and called her up. And then the next thing you knew, you had married, what's her name, Jane, lined up for the night.
Right.
And then between that and another, we stopped. While I came back, you were talking to a girl at the truck. And then I had to go tell her you were busy. You remember that? It was three of them in less than an hour. Everyone he met, he loved. I'll be there in an hour, honey.
I was just head over heels in love with this girl, and she wanted us to get married. And she wanted me to sing to her. I'd sing a love song. And can you imagine that? And she loved it.
No wonder she disappeared.
So,
I think her next stop was East Mississippi.
Yeah. Finally, I told her, I said, now
what
listen.
What do you think, old friend?
I said, I love you and all like that, but I said, I don't make enough money, you know, for us to live. And she was dating a guy that worked for the railroad. And he made, you know, even back then, pretty good money. And I said, I tell you, what you better do. If we get married, we just don't make enough money to eat and have a place to stay and buy anything, clothes, anything. Yeah. And I said, well, you just keep on going with him and see if you get hooked up. And she did. It didn't take long. But you know, she died. Wasn't too long.
Yeah.
And I figured she died because
How about that?
You didn't know you were kidding that guy.